I was talking about this with Jessica and Frank and Mark, this really loving and lovely documentary about Natalie Wood. It's been put together in large part by her daughter, who joins us live. We're so happy to have you. Here comes, there's so many, Natasha, Gregson, Wagner. Natasha, nice to speak to you. And one part I loved about this so much, when you talked about having your own daughter and how much that meant to you.
Well, having my own daughter shifted the focus for me so much away from being motherless and becoming a mother myself. It was just the most healing thing that's ever happened.
Well, I tell you what, the whole thing, I think, must be healing to a large degree. And one thing that you do, which is amazingly brave, I think, is we all know the tabloid headlines surrounding your mother's death. You are very close, obviously, with your stepfather, Robert Wagner. And you actually have an interview with him where you talk all about this. It's amazing to me.
Well, you know, we knew that we had to deal with it because it was the elephant in the room. And I just said directly to my dad, you know, let's just handle this head on. Let's just talk about it, because I've talked about it with him before, obviously, you know, privately, but he's such a man of grace and elegance. I felt that, you know, him speaking about it on camera would hopefully quell a lot of this nonsense.
This idea of the nonsense and the noise and the reopening of an investigation, how does that all feel? Because I think on one level, you know, we're talking about magazines and tabloids that make money. And on another level,
right,
we're talking about your mom.
Absolutely. I mean, I think, you know, so many people that didn't know my mom have profited off of her death with the tabloids and all this media speculation. For my family and myself, it's been very painful. And you know, the case was reopened in 2011 when I was pregnant with my daughter. And I was so concerned about my father. I didn't want him to feel, I didn't want him to drop dead from the stress of it, but he handled it as he always does with such character. And you know, I want the focus of my mom to be on her life. That's what I want. I mean, as you can see from the documentary, she lived such an amazing, stunning life. And she was such a great mom. You know, I want to share her with the world.
I think you've very successfully accomplished that. So many movies starting when she was just a child. We're going to look at a little bit of the documentary. Here we go. Look.
She was owned by the studio, and she didn't want to be owned. She wanted to have control over the choices. I mean, if she's going to spend 3 months doing a film, she wants to believe in it. So she took on Jack Warner and told him, "I'm going to go on strike because I don't like the roles that you're choosing for me."
The suspension lasted about 18 months, so that the punishment was that if you wouldn't work for them, you couldn't work anywhere else either. Right. It wasn't that I was trying to get more money. That really wasn't it at all. But what I eventually did get the right to do was the right to choose one picture a year that, you know, was my choice. The first one that I was able to choose was West Side Story.
Oh, my gosh. In addition to the documentary, you have a book out about your mother, and obviously you knew her as a young girl growing up till your 11th year. More Than Love, we're looking at a cover of the book now. What did you discover about her, perhaps, that you didn't know as you put this book together?
Well, you know, I did know so much, but I think what I really just cemented for me was her deep desire to know herself, to be a self-reflective person. And to really, you know, she took on the responsibilities in her life so deeply: motherhood, acting, being a wife, being a friend, you know, supporting the causes she believed in. And so for me, I'm just so proud of her, and I'm proud to be her daughter. And I'm proud of the bond that I share with her, you know, that loving bond. And I have found motherhood to be, you know, a beautifully fulfilling job. And I think I learned that from my own mom.
I tell you what, you have done an absolutely beautiful job on this documentary. Congratulations to you. Really appreciate you joining us today. Thanks so much. Thanks,
really,
Natasha.
I appreciate it.
Again, Natalie Wood, What Remains Behind, is now available on HBO On Demand, HBO Now, HBO Go. The book, More Than Love, An Intimate Portrait of My Mother, Natalie Wood, is out now.